Marfan syndrome is called a syndrome because there's a lot of different physical things that occur together that people have recognized as a pattern. So some of those things include very tall, thin body habitus. Sometimes you can see people, they have a characteristic structure to their face. Sometimes they'll have a longer face, more narrow face, flat cheekbones. Well, I was diagnosed when I was 5, but the diagnosis was very hard for me to get. And so my parents were determined to know whether I had Marfan syndrome or not. So they took me to multiple specialists throughout Kentucky, and everyone said, no, Mary's fine. One specialist said, Mary looks too normal to have Marfan syndrome. And my dad kept noticing that all the literature that was being written was coming from Johns Hopkins. So before they agreed to any surgical procedures, they took me to Johns Hopkins so they would know for sure whether or not I had Marfan syndrome. And when I went there, I saw a geneticist, and he said to my parents, there's no doubt in my mind that Mary has Marfan syndrome. I had a really amazing doctor at Johns Hopkins, and her name was Claire Francomano. And I just remember feeling so comfortable with her, and I admired her. I remember driving home with my mom after one of my appointments, and I said to her, I want to do what Claire does. I didn't understand why I had to go all the way to Johns Hopkins to see my doctors, because I had to leave all my family and my friends. When I had my surgery there, I was in Baltimore for a month. My goal when I was little, I said, I want to be a geneticist like Claire, but I want to do it in Kentucky. Everything lined up for me. When I was an incoming freshman, they had just started a new program called the Professional Student Mentored Research Fellowship. And I applied for that program, and I was awarded a research stipend to work with a principal investigator here at UK. And so I was excited about the opportunity, and I knew I was interested in Marfan syndrome, but I didn't know anyone who was doing research in that field. So I started talking to people, and they recommended me to Dr. Estus. And Dr. Estus was doing a lot of molecular techniques in his laboratory, and he just found out about my passion for Marfan syndrome and said, okay, well, let's see what we can find out. So his idea was to look at splicing in the gene that is known to have mutations that cause Marfan syndrome. And so that's what we did. We went through, and what we did was what we call a scan, which is we looked at all the different exons in the gene of fibrillin to look for different exons that were cryptically spliced. And in the end, we did find 2 cryptically spliced exons, one that had never been recognized, even knew that it existed, one that was in the literature but had never been published. It was really amazing. I just started talking to all these different professors and learning about their jobs. And one of the professors I talked to was Dr. Daugherty, who's the Dean of Research here at UK. And when I went in, he asked me about my research. I told him I was passionate and interested in Marfan syndrome. Well, he walked over to his desk, and he lifted up a pamphlet, which was an application for the National Marfan Foundation McCusick Research Award, which is the biggest research grant that the National Marfan Foundation has.
So we had a conversation about, as a physician, what it's like to be a researcher, what you have to do to be able to get to the. And then she asked me about what research we were doing. And we just stumbled into this area of Marfan's literally months before that. And so, we had a half-hour meeting that went on for about an hour and a half because we covered a whole range of topics.
I just thought, what are the odds, that this is my interest and he's interested in it too?
Probably my biggest education has been with talking to Mary and spending quite a bit of time with her. And then we discussed the symposium that we went to where this was not just a scientific symposium, but there was also advocacy groups and individuals with Marfan's that were involved in this group. So, as I say, in the last year or so, I've come involved with this group a lot more. The National Marfan's Foundation is a very, very involved group of individuals. It's relatively small, but once a year they offer this Victor McCusick Fellowship. So Victor McCusick was a Hopkins physician who's kind of considered to be the father of genetic human disease research. And so they've named one fellowship after him. And we had a Xiaofeng, she's a MD, PhD from China that works in my lab, who before she came to my lab had published on thoracic aneurysms in China. And so, she it was just sort of a combination of I was having this model, her having this background, and we applied for this fellowship, and she got a 2-year fellowship funded by the National Marfan Foundation.
So there's still a lot of people who have Marfan syndrome and don't know it. I was really lucky because my dad was a doctor, and he could read the literature, and he had the means to take me out of the state and try to get advice from experts. And so I do hope to help change that. I've always loved Kentucky. I had a great experience at college when I went to center. And when I wanted to go to medical school, I wanted to stay here. I wanted to be close to my family, and I knew that I had every opportunity to do things here as I would anywhere else. But I have absolutely no intention of practicing anywhere other than Kentucky. This is my home, and I know that this is where, you know, patients need good doctors.